afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Horses are now on the racetrack for today's featured event, the Virginia Crown. Post time in 3 minutes. Sugar Tap is loaded into the starting gate. Rancher Rick, Eddie Gal, the last two to go in. Horses are all in line for the start of the Virginia Crown.
Missing the party.
I'll be right there. Great bonus, huh, Daddy? Marion, it's so good to us. I can't wait to start working them out. Hey, Starliner?
Come on back to the party, sweetheart. You're your own person. You know that, don't you?
Seen Terry for a while.
Oh, she's around here somewhere.
Well, I'm surprised she's letting you run around all loose.
Well, I'm not on a leash, you know.
Well, I'm happy to hear it.
Marion, Julia, excuse us, please.
Excuse me.
I'm going to pay some more attention to your wife.
Will she run off again?
She'll be back.
Terry?
No, don't do that. You are beautiful. I thank God for you.
Attention, please. Attention. Will you all just hush up now? Please. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please join me in raising your glasses to the one man who is responsible for my just winning the Virginia Crown? He is the finest horse trainer who ever lived, Mr. Frank Hadley.
Thank you, Marion. Well, when I started out as a young horse trainer, I never dreamed that the world could be so kind to me. My dear wife, Joanne, was with me during all the hard times early on. My only regret is she wasn't there to share the gravy. But she did leave me one precious gift. A person who's as responsible for the success of our stables as I am. And she can crunch numbers better than any CPA. I'm talking about my daughter, Terry.
Yeah.
And I guess I'd be remiss if I didn't mention her husband, Virgil. The best assistant horse trainer in the country. That is, he will be if he ever learns the difference between a horse's head and a horse's... Little joke there, Virgil. Thank you. Thank y'all.
It has been 10 years.
Honey, we are making progress. Now, your blood count is coming along nicely. A few more years, and then we can think about removing those scars.
How many is a few more?
Please, doctor. We were really hoping for some better news today.
I know this is all new to you, Virgil, but we are doing everything that can be done. This surgery is going to take over a year. And the risk of infection is just too great with the factor 8 deficiency in the blood. We just have to keep building up those lymphocytes.
Yes, I'm good. Listen, we need to go ahead and issue that check to the co-op for our grain. I know we're only 2 months behind, but I don't want to be late with Mr. Walker because he's such a dear to us and gives us his best grain. Well, I show $37,000 in this account. I did not authorize that. He did. Oh, God, no, don't tell Daddy. Just let me, check on that.
Hey, honey, Terry!
Virgil, there is $30,000 missing from supplies and salaries account. Do you know anything about that?
Honey, I was hoping I could put that back before you found out about it.
How could you gamble away $30,000 that doesn't even belong to you?
Honey, it was just a loan. I thought if I'd won that we'd have enough, a stake, we could start our own stables.
Our own stables? Well, we're doing fine here with Daddy. We're partners.
You and your daddy are partners. I'm no better a stable hand. Honey, I'm sorry. My debts just seem to snowball on me, baby. Look, we got married for better or for worse. And I guess this is the worst, but I promise you, I will pay back every cent. You're the only thing that matters to me. You are my favorite princess.
Under a minute, Frank.
He's a great mover.
I've just been going over the books. Did you think I wouldn't notice that Terry's covering up for you?
Don't blame Terry, sir. It's my fault.
You've been losing big at the track, haven't you?
Yes, sir.
Terry, we've been over this before.
Sorry, Daddy.
Look, I'm going to put that money back, Frank. I'll do whatever it takes.
You said that before, Virgil. I don't know what I'm going to do with you.
Daddy, please. Please, Daddy.
Look, I'm sorry, Frank. I'm sorry.
He's sorry, Daddy.
You're sorry?
Yes, sir.
Are you, Virgil? Are you really sorry? You know, you got all that charm going for you. That's why I trusted you. That's why Terry wants you. Shame of it is, I don't believe you're sorry for a damn thing.
It's not true, Frank. It's just not true. Look, haven't you ever made a mistake? Yeah, haven't you?
Look, if this ever happens again, I will prefer charges. I will not have you or anybody else wreck a business that I've spent 25 years building up.
You don't have to worry about that, Frank. I promise. I quit betting. Not my money or anybody else's.
Yeah. Take this horse. Walk around 15 minutes, cool her out.
Yes, sir.
Tends to pull back at the first turn, so keep him tight going in.
Don't use the whip on the final stretch, because it won't help.
Post time. 3 minutes. 3 minutes until post time.
I guess I'm still in the doghouse.
He'll come around.
Yeah, I'm sure. Come on.
Here's Dazzling Dreamer taking his position at the starting gate. Before the sixth race is loaded and ready to go. And they're off. Dazzling Dreamer comes out of the gate like a rocket, going right up for the early lead. Turning for home, and Dazzling Dreamer has a six-length lead on the rest of the field. He's all alone in front. Veronica's Daddy races in second. Baby Cage is third. It's Dazzling Dreamer in the stretch, way out in front. And now Dazzling Dreamer is starting to go to the outside of the track. Something appears to be wrong with Dazzling Dreamer. Veronica's Daddy now going on by to take the lead. Baby Cage in second. Before Scott is third. Will be Veronica's Daddy is winning, but something is serious.
George, you've known me since we were kids. I've never juiced a horse and never would. I don't even know what drugs look like, much less where to get them.
I believe you, Frank. Don't have something to hide. Shouldn't be a problem.
We're just following procedure, Mr. Hadley. There appears to be about $30,000 missing from your accounts.
Well, I can explain that.
I got busy. Got a little sloppy with the bookkeeping.
You have investors in your stables, don't you?
What are you implying?
You placed a significant bet on Dazzling Dreamer, didn't you?
Well, trainers bet on their horses all the time. He was the best horse in the race. We knew that. Nobody else did.
Yeah.
We thought it was pretty much a sure thing.
Well, certainly no horse is a sure thing unless he's been enhanced somehow.
I resent that. You have absolutely no evidence we've done anything wrong.
You recognize this?
Yes. We use those to open a horse's airways when he's not breathing properly.
Did you use it on Dazzling Dreamer before the race?
Yes, we did.
I did.
Could it be used to spray, say, cocaine into a horse's lungs?
Been done.
But not by us. You just take that to your lab and have it checked out. You see, there's nothing but air in that tube.
What our lab confirmed in that tube are traces of fresh cocaine.
George, I'm having dinner with my lawyer tonight. Why don't you come join us? We can... Look, George, we've been friends for... I understand your hands are tied. But ask yourself one question, George. Who tied them? Well, State Racing Commission's lifted our license and withdrawn sanctions from our stables until this mess is over with.
Oh, Daddy.
Damn! I can't believe this. You wouldn't know anything about this, would you, Virgil?
No, sir, I don't.
Big win on Dreamer would put you out of hot water with the bookies.
I didn't place any bets.
I promise I quit betting, and I have.
You wouldn't mind if I checked that out, I guess.
No, sir, I don't. Go ahead, I want you to.
Why would he do that when we all knew Dreamer would win, did he?
And after you check that out, it's my hope, sir, that you'll believe me when I say that I love Terry more than my own life. See, I'd never do anything to hurt her.
No, honey. Sometimes I think Virgil doesn't give a damn for anybody but himself. And he talks about you, and I think maybe he does have a heart after all.
He makes me happy, Daddy.
That's all I want, honey. See you later.
I'll be around next week to settle up. Thanks, Joe.
Maybe. I know they're more expensive, but I could go to these galvanized meats. Maybe even some of these galvanized feeders. I know they're more expensive. I might pick up a couple of them.
Doing here? I thought you were in the army.
Oh, I was. Blew out my knee on maneuvers. Took my disability money and bought me some trucks. I'll be starting up on my own, I think.
You gonna start up around here?
Transporting horses to the courses. Yeah, I know trucks and no horses.
Well, Piedmont Valley has a lot of both.
You saying I shouldn't have come home? Terry, I heard about your dad, and I'm really sorry. Got married.
Yeah, 6 months ago. I guess I finally had to move on.
Terry, you're as direct as always. Is he a good guy?
He's the best.
I'm glad. You deserve the best. I thought a lot about you. I still think about what might have happened if I'd have stayed.
I never do.
Terry? Heard about your trouble. You and Frank could have never done anything like that. If there's anything I can do.
I appreciate that, Sam. I'll see you around.
Storm,
yeah. Something bothering you, boy?
Boy's been going crazy on me around here all day. Can't seem to get him to calm down any. Oh, son.
What seems to be the trouble? Aha. Mm-hmm. Give it here. Mm-hmm. Give it here.
Put a blanket on
him. Honey, should I call Doc Conrad?
No, I'll take care of it. He's just got a couple of broken blood vessels on his ankle.
Look, honey, it's just not such a good idea, you know? You shouldn't even be handling the feed and grain with the trial coming up in all next week.
Well, everything's in your name. What difference does it make anyway?
It's just not such a good idea for you to be seen around here right now. I mean, we already lost too many owners. And the others, that they think you're still running things around here, they're liable to take off as well. I'm sorry, honey. It's just the way things have to be.
You say the Hadleys were straight people, and yet wasn't there an attempt to defraud investors?
Absolutely not.
Didn't your wife misappropriate $30,000 from stable accounts meant to cover operational costs?
No. I used that money to cover some personal debts.
But isn't it a fact that she was the one that manipulated the books?
Yes, but...
Yes or no? Did you or anyone else ask or instruct her to manipulate those books?
No.
Thank you. That'll be all, Mr. Chance.
You may step down, Mr. Chance.
Now, if Dazzling Dreamer had won that race, wouldn't that have solved your financial problems?
Objection. Cause for speculation.
Sustained.
Withdrawn. Mrs. Chance, you were aware, were you not, that the odds on your horse that day were 8-1?
Well, I really don't pay any attention to that.
But you knew that the odds were 8-1.
Oh, yes.
So isn't it true, with the wager of $5,000, your horse winning would have netted you $40,000?
Yes.
Wouldn't $40,000 have solved your financial problems?
Objection. Leading the witness.
Overruled. Answer the question, Mrs. Chance.
Yes.
And that's why you drugged your horse, isn't it?
No. I mean, no. I did not drug him.
No.
There must be some mistake. Daddy and I do not drug horses. We love them very much.
But can you explain how fresh cocaine got on the tube which you handled just prior to the race?
Racing must keep its good name clean. The sentence of this court is that Terry Hadley Chance be remanded to the Virginia Institution for Women for the term prescribed by law of not more than 3 years and not less than 1 year. Court is adjourned.
Dropped it.
We'll clean it up.
Want some chocolate?
No, thank you.
I need something
to stop me. Let me take a look at it.
Please.
You're scared, honey.
Please. Please don't.
We'll see you later. We grabbed it.
I don't know. These
packs are
gonna be.
You better wise up. You're gonna be in trouble.
What happened to your face? Somebody cut you?
No. I was in an accident when I was 17.
Tough break, kiddo.
Only now, it's gonna get tougher. They're all waiting for some bitch to call you out. Stand up for yourself. They'll take everything from you.
And what do you want?
Lady, sure got a privilege.
Keep your medal.
Excuse me. Miss? Thank you.
Just don't forget what I said. Never. Know where I learned that? Business school. It's They always figure best way to get someplace in this world.
Back off.
To work a nice office, wear stylish clothes, and count money all day long.
I studied investment banking at Piedmont Valley College.
Yeah, I turned down Harvard too. So you in the laundry business?
Excuse me?
God, you are green. I ran the books for a club in Richmond. A place to wash the money for the big boys up in the Big Apple in D.C. Dirty cash in, clean cash out. I'm Della Ray Sanders.
Terry Hadley Chance.
What?
Terry Hadley Chance. Please tell me some good news. Any word on my appeal?
Honey, the DA is fighting us on this. It could be a year before we hear anything. Yeah, I know. I'm doing everything I can think of, honey.
What about the stables? Are the owners coming back?
I want to talk to you about that. I want you to hear me out before you say anything.
Okay.
We got some big problems. I mean, our reputation has been hurt by this whole mess, and I'm not having much success getting any of our old clients back, not even the stray boarders.
What?
I love you, you know that?
I love you.
Now, our love runs deeper than any piece of paper, don't it?
Yes.
Honey, I think I can save our stables if we get a divorce. No. We don't need no government or anybody else to tell us that we love each other.
Virgil.
At worst, you'll be in here 3 years. That's if we have no luck at all. But when you get out, we still have our future to look after.
Virgil, I don't think I can do that.
Honey.
Please.
Sweetheart, you have to. I need you to sign this so I can try to save our business.
I can't.
You remember when I first went to work for your daddy? And I wasn't even allowed up near the house. And one night I saw you sitting outside all alone crying your eyes out. I ran to you. I put my arms around you and I never let go. I never felt more needed in my entire life. Until now. Honey, let me do this for us. Let me say the thing that means the most to you. I can't think of anything else. I mean, I've racked my brain trying to think of any other way.
Virgil.
Here. I'll never leave you here. I love you.
I love you.
Honey, I gotta go. I gotta get this whole thing started. I'll be back next week, sweetheart, in visitation.
Situation, Virgil. You owe me 4% a week, every week.
I'm telling you, I'm not going to sell the horses. I'm going to run stables myself.
Really?
Yes, ma'am.
Where the hell do you get off saying something like that to me? I fix it for your old lady and her daddy to take the fall, and now you're weaseling out on the deal?
I just need a little time. I'm going to pay back everything I owe, plus 20% of my winnings.
If you win, we had a deal, Virgil.
I'm offering you a better one.
You really are something. You think you can have it all your own way, don't you?
You have 8 minutes remaining on your phone time.
Evening, boss.
Dietary supplement for Slipgate's feed Saturday morning. Something for your trouble?
Done.
Thank you. They say all horse players die broke.
Well, all horse players don't die broke. Most of them die owing money.
What you doing out here all by your lonesome?
Oh, I don't know. Adding up my life, I guess.
You should add up pretty well. You've won a few races.
I guess I don't like being alone.
Alone? You have got parties going here every night.
That's just a good act, that's all.
Mm-hmm. So is this one.
Hey, it's not worked out yet. First time I tried it out on you and it almost got you. Admit it.
You don't need an act with me. I've always had a thing for you.
Rodriguez.
Thank you, ma'am.
Well, he hasn't come by written since you signed those papers. Must be real busy keeping them stables going for you. Pretty convenient, huh? Dad is gone. He only has you. Squeeze out of the stables. Wake up. He used you. Quit being a stupid, trusting victim.
Stop it.
What you gonna tell me? It was your good looks that caught him? Your great body? No, baby. It was your daddy's money.
Shut up!
You're stupid. You really are stupid. Your brain is as fried as that face of yours.
When you're gonna come visit me, huh? You want some chocolate?
No.
Just a little chocolate.
Come on, you don't need this. That's a girl.
Want something else? Want something else? Want to go somewhere else?
Mina! Look! Let's get some juice. Stop it! Stop it! No! No, you're not! Leave me! Stop it!
Want another beauty mark? Terry, are you awake? You're in St. Joseph's Hospital. Do you understand me?
How bad, Emma?
I'd like to talk to you about that. My name's Dr. Winston. I run a national group of plastic surgeons. We all volunteer time to help women like you. Mostly, the battered women have been assaulted.
They have served.
Chronic lymphocytic deficiency. I assume that's why you never had the scars removed. Mm. All those years of treatment finally paid off. And with the newest laser techniques, they're quite acceptable.
Here, I'm going to leave Virginia, so I will need your help.
Sure, I can.
I need someone who can provide me with a new identity. A birth certificate, social security number, a new background.
Cost?
Well, I can pay off any reasonable amount given time. You mark my words, I will be the toughest businesswoman you ever saw. Investment companies want people who can make them big money.
Not with the prison record.
Well, that's why I need a new name.
Everything planned to perfection, huh? Brains. They rattle a little. But they're in there.
What do you think?
Enough's enough, Alice. Come on. It's time now. Alice, what are you doing?
It just dropped again.
No, it's still working. It'll keep making money until the key indicator commodity bottoms out.
You've got to get out.
Hang on. I want to watch this cat bounce. Come on.
Get out now.
Come on. That's it. Let's clean out this position.
She did it.
Do I know what I'm doing? Did I tell you? Rob, you gotta listen to me, buddy. Chinese bonds are about to launch. 1153 is a great yield. This one is going to the moon.
Do we buy 10 million?
Nope, buy 100 million.
You lousy little pirate. You stole that Zincon IPO right out from under me.
Fair game. I didn't hold a gun to their head. Your positions are a mess and they're getting worse. I knew it, they knew it.
How'd they know it?
Dickie, you gotta start getting to the office a little earlier. I mean, it's Wall Street. Money never sleeps. You like it?
Mm-hmm.
Not too overpowering.
No, ma'am. Just enough to drive me crazy.
You sure know how to avoid talking about money.
No. How much I owe you? 2019?
Oh, looks on a brain, too.
Mm-hmm.
2019 on the nose.
Interest only, of course.
Here's $1,019. I'll get you another G next week.
No, don't do this to me, Virgil. You gotta pay all the juice.
You get it. Don't you always get it? Huh?
Listen, you're in for over $100,000. And my connections could pin your tab on me personal. You don't want that.
I'll take care, man. You look good today.
You watch her back.
This time?
20,000.
Not again.
Honey.
You promised.
It's just a loan, baby. A loan.
What do you have with a little more class?
The municipal portfolio needs a safety net.
Neither one of us is going to get rich off safety nets. Did you put in a good word for me with Mr. Lukacs?
I told you. I talked to Rhonda, his secretary, at length. He's got your prospectus and she'll do what she can. You'll just have to wait.
But my sources say he's ready to move accounts now.
Well, get in line. Mr. $1.2 billion isn't going to hire you off my recommendation. Look, Rhonda's trying. That's all I can do.
Thank you. Hi, Rhonda. This is Allison Bevins again, and I was just hoping that there might be a chance. Yes. Okay. Mr. Lukacs. Hi, Allison Bevins. You got my prospectus. Oh, good, because I worked a solid year on it. Wonderful. I don't suppose you like horse racing. Yes, because there's a running at Fairfield on the 8th, and I have a table at the Turf Terrace. Wonderful. Well, I look so forward to it. I'll see you in Baltimore. Mr. Lukacs?
Miss Bevins? That is not the color one expects on an investment banker.
Apricot? Well, it's the most beautiful color God made.
Oh, I was expecting hunter's green, since you are such a ferocious hunter of other people's clients.
Well, I make my living offering financial advice. It's up to other people whether they take it or not.
Well, I'm afraid you are almost certainly wasting your time.
Well, then I won't send you a bill.
Is this the kind of place where you normally conduct business?
Would you rather go over bond issues and yield reports in an office?
That is what comes to mind with an investment banker.
Well, I hope to shatter a few of your preconceptions today, Mr. Lukacs.
Well, you already have with that dress.
As he came into my field, he picked the sweetest apricot way before her time.
You know about my wife.
I've had tragedy in my life, too. I know what it's like.
Doris Fussell's poetry helped me to get through her death. Well, you've certainly done your research.
Oh, a little.
A little. Nobody knows about that.
Okay, I dug.
You should have been a detective.
Well, that'll be my midlife career change if I start losing my clients' money.
I have a feeling that's not going to happen.
Not today, because I'm buying. Anything you like.
See it? Watch.
Yes.
I lost on these, and I won on these. Take this in, and I'll get your elegant strawberry. Two.
That's amazing. 6 out of 7 to win? Do you always have that much luck?
Luck is a poor excuse for good horse sense. Thanks, Randy. There's Starlight. It's a great horse.
You bet her every time out.
Mr. Chance.
Uh-huh.
Allison Bevins. I'm a great admirer of yours.
Have we met?
I don't think so.
May I introduce Leon Lukacs?
Oh, Mr. Lukacs, it's a real pleasure. This here's my wife, Julia.
You're a bit of an international something, I hear.
That just about describes it.
Julia, this man owns half the real estate in Florida.
Just a few properties, although it is true I sometimes need a compass to find my mailbox.
Easy, Stalin.
Well, careful there. I don't want to take a nip out of you. He's still pumped up after the race.
He likes her.
Well, Stalin, it doesn't take to too many people that way.
Jason, take him away.
Come on, go boy.
I'm afraid I don't know too much about horses, but I am interested in investing in them. How is your stock?
Oh, world class. Lean and fast.
Well, maybe I should come down to Virginia and check it out for myself.
Well, you'd be most welcome. I'll make you a good deal.
Well, I only make good deals. Leon, it's getting late. It's nice to have met you both.
Good luck with the season.
Thank you.
Do you know her?
No, ma'am.
If I can't double your money in a year, then you can fire me. But if I succeed, then you give me the rest of your portfolio to manage, 5% off the top.
Horses? I never thought of horses as much of an investment.
Yep, neither does Wall Street, but the breeding of thoroughbreds is a big business, just like textiles and banking and computer chips.
How's that?
Well, they're training and breeding horses in Virginia that sell for millions of dollars. I mean, it is one of the last big undiscovered investment plays in this country.
Well, it still sounds like too much of a gamble for me.
Well, not when I put together the biggest blood stock operation in Virginia's history. There's a lot of high quality horse farms just waiting to be bought up and consolidated.
It's crazy. It's absolutely crazy.
It's no more crazy than a 25-year-old son of a shoesmith that bought marginal swamp land and turned it into a world-class resort.
That's my first real estate deal.
Sold it 3 years later and made a profit of $3 million. I can do a lot better than that in Clark County. Excuse me, is this the laundromat?
Can I help you?
Guys were concerned, my serving time was like being a regular Joan of Arc. I did for them, they done for me. Offered me my own place. How can I say no?
I want to show you something.
Your old stables.
I want Virgil to learn what it feels like to lose everything.
Oh, so that's what this is all about.
I just thought that maybe...
If I can keep an eye on Virgil and let you know if I hear of anything useful.
I hate to ask you to do it, but you're the only one I know trustworthy enough and shady enough.
Let me tell you something. There's some guys in Richmond who will take care of anybody if the price is right.
No, it's too shady. I want justice.
Thank you.
back. I'll have a check waiting for you here.
All right, I'll pull right up over there.
All right, go ahead. I'll look for you.
Galvin? Hi, Allison Bevins. My secretary spoke to you earlier.
Hi. Don't I know you from somewhere?
Is that a line, Mr. Galvin?
Not unless you'd like it to be.
I wouldn't. My business is strictly horses.
Well, we'll move them any place you'd like.
And I'm going to ask you to do exactly that in a few months. But in the meantime, I need someone to introduce me to the right people.
Excuse me?
Well, I'm looking for stock and stables to buy, and I thought maybe you could make a few introductions.
Well, I have a business to run.
I'll make it worth your while.
You say that to all the guys?
Only when I have to.
Oh, I'm afraid I don't have time to take on anything like that right now. I'm sorry.
Can you take on $5,000?
U.S. or Confederate?
I'm serious. Consider it an advance on future business.
You are mighty bushy-tailed for a new arrival.
Listen, I'm writing you a check right now. You can use it to fix up your shop and put a down payment on those two trucks you've been wanting to buy.
What are you, a cop?
No, just a woman who needs an interesting man as an escort to the jockey club ball.
Well, I guess I might be that man.
Beautiful.
What's our first move?
Dance with me, Mr. Galvin.
On one condition.
What's that?
You stop calling me Mr. Galvin.
All right, Sam. May I have this dance?
Enchanted, Allison. Beautiful.
I do.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you. Tell me about Virgil Chance. I'm thinking about doing a business deal with him.
You'd be lucky to walk away with your skivvies.
Oh, you don't like him?
I don't like what he did to his first wife.
Yeah, I heard she was in prison.
She loved horses. She could never dope any animal.
And that's his wife, Julia?
Yeah, he's running through her inheritance faster than an odds-on filly. I figure she must really love him.
Guess it happens. Miss Chance, Allison Bevins. We met at the running at Fairfield.
Oh, sure. You were looking to buy into the horse business.
Hey, Julia.
Hello, Sam.
Well, I might as well confess my deepest, darkest secret. I represent a client who's expressed interest in your stables.
Our stables? Well, they're not for sale.
Well, you haven't heard my offer.
Well, I don't need to. Perhaps I could introduce you to one of our neighbors. He's a wonderful trainer, very nice stables.
I see you accepted my invitation, Miss Bevins.
Mr. Chance, I'm flattered you remember.
How could I forget, huh? I'm just sure that we met before, like Louisville, perhaps.
Sorry, no. Mrs. Whitney, I've always been such a great admirer of yours.
Really? How kind of you to say so.
And I look forward to seeing your next winner.
Thank you.
Trained by Mr. Chance, no doubt. If he can hang on to his stables.
I beg your pardon.
What's that supposed to mean?
Oh, well, the Chance stables are involved in a rather complex tax litigation, according to the county records.
It's nothing.
Virgil?
I got a handle.
Hope you can handle the banks, because I gather they haven't been paid either.
Virgil, what is this?
Isn't that something? And sooner or later, no matter what we talk about, we always end up talking about money and taxes.
You're here. You are misinformed, Miss Bevins.
Am I?
Mm-hmm.
Well, my apologies. Well, it was so nice seeing you all. Marion?
My dear.
That was fine. Blissfully fine.
Virgil, what was you talking about?
Oh, no, just a little something. Can I get you a drink, sweetie?
So if you do decide to do that, give her a call.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you for your time.
Thank you. Hey, listen.
Hmm?
I'm off the clock.
Meaning?
Meaning I know a nice, cool lake where we could untie our shoelace and just go for a swim.
I'd love to, but I've got to get up early in the morning.
Hey, this weekend there's a county fair coming up. Nothing fancy like tonight, but you wear a pretty dress, put a ribbon in your hair, and I just might waltz you around under that moon.
I've really got a lot of work to do.
You don't mind me asking?
No, I consider it a compliment.
Yeah, ma'am.
Thank you.
Good, I'll keep asking.
Sam, for the time being, I'd prefer it if we kept it just business.
I'll remember you said for the time being. Good night.
No, they were just scaring him. Horses hate fire more than anything.
And what were you doing out there?
Well, I had taken a drive to clear my head and ended up on a road by the stables and saw the flames through the trees.
Hiya, Jenny.
Hey.
Johnny's expecting us.
What is he up to?
Mr. Perry?
Now, your bank holds the deed on those stables, doesn't it, Jonathan?
Well, I'm sorry, Miss Bevins. That information is confidential.
Well, given the extent of Mr. Chance's back taxes and debts, perhaps you could tell me why you've held them back from an open market sale.
Well, Virgil Chance is one of our most prominent clients.
And the most unreliable with his loan payments.
Mm-hmm. Well, I couldn't possibly discuss that. Except to say that he's very much current right now.
You should know, Jonathan, Miss Bevins can send you a lot more business than Virgil.
Well, naturally, we are always interested in new accounts.
You're not getting a piece of his action now, are you?
I don't know what you mean.
Well, you know that trip that you took to Las Vegas last month? Everything on the house, plane, room, drinks.
That's just too incredible an accusation to take seriously.
Well, wouldn't you love to have Virgil pick up your tabs? I bet your board would be interested in hearing about that.
My board?
You wouldn't mind me asking for a meeting with him, would you? Thank you for your time.
Look, Allison, I really want to help you, but you've got to tell me what's going on.
Sam, I told you.
Now, I know you told me, but these people are my friends. You can't treat them like this.
We have an agreement.
Then you can just have your check back.
Sam, listen.
No, you listen. If this is going to involve hurting people, I don't want any part of it.
Since when did you become so noble?
And just what in the hell is that supposed to mean? I don't imagine someone like you would understand this. But friends are important to me. I don't make a habit of using them or hurting them. And I'm certainly not going to be the one to let them down.
Is that right?
Yes, that's right. I had to learn that the hard way.
How's that?
It was a girl I knew. Something really bad happened to her. She needed me more than she ever had. I couldn't handle it. Instead of just telling her the truth, I ran away. She was the best friend I ever had, and I'd give anything if I could just take that back. You really don't need to know all this. Just take me off the payroll. We'll leave it at that. I'm sorry.
Hey, boss. Boss, Ms. Bivens is here.
Oh, thanks, Nick. Take over here.
You bet.
Ms. Bivens! I'm glad you decided to come.
Well, I'm glad you decided to call.
Well, I didn't want you to misunderstand Jonathan. He didn't realize we were friends.
Well, I understand Jonathan acts like he's sitting on a hot seat.
No, nothing like that. Just sometimes folks around here can be suspicious of strangers, hang over from the old days, the old South.
Oh, I thought the tradition of the old South was hospitality.
Oh, I'm trying to be hospitable, Allison. It's just tough when someone comes around trying to strong-arm folks.
Well, I thought winners get out front and take a lead.
Maybe you should think about taking a breather. There must be something I can do for you.
Sell.
Breaks my heart to say no.
Well, guess there's nothing you can do for me. Kind of wondering what I'm doing here.
I thought I could at least show you around the place. How'd you like that?
I would.
I want to show you my latest acquisition. Got him at auction. I figure he can go all the way to the Triple Crown.
Oh, goodness. He's magnificent. Easy, boy. What's wrong with him?
He's just a little junkie coming off the car.
What are you doing?
I want you to take a closer look at what you're getting into.
Open this gate.
You see what Black Planet is up for?
Let me out of here.
Ah. You're not so tough after all. Wow. I sure do hope nothing like that ever happens to you again. Hope you enjoyed your tour.
Thank you, Christophe. By the way, interesting about that Bevins woman. She was correct about your books.
Hmm?
Well, I asked Julia to see them. I didn't think you'd mind.
I thought it'd be all right. I mean, the stable's all the collateral for the loan that she gave us.
Well, sure, but I can't believe...
Well, I can't believe that you're paying wages for more stable hands than you employ.
Yeah, it must be an accounting error.
Of course.
Oh, like the overages on supplies, transportation, and entertainment.
Well, now, if you have found some discrepancies, Marion, I will look right into it.
Thank you, Virgil. Right before a big race, especially, I would hate to have to initiate a nasty audit.
Mother.
Now, there's no need for that, Marion. You go over them books like a flying wallpaper. I want you to promise me something. You kick my tail if you find anything questionable.
Thank you, Virgil. I'll do that.
Ginger Charles, I don't want you waiting up for me. I'm going to be having a late supper with some friends in town. Thank you, Daniel.
Almost 500,000 plus interest every week, and he barely makes the interest.
He's desperate. That's good.
You don't know what you're getting yourself into. Virgil owes his soul to a tiger woman named Loretta Salido. You think Virgil is dangerous? This woman will cut you up and salt you like a hawk.
Well, she's not interested in me.
Allison, this woman is not going to let anybody drag Virgil down when he owes her that much money.
Well, I can't stop now.
Girl, you better let it go.
Can you tell us anything more about Marion Whitney's condition?
The body of Marion Whitney was found today in the wreckage of her car on this road in Clark County, just south of the Richmond Freeway. She was renowned throughout the state as a wealthy philanthropist and a highly successful thoroughbred owner. A preliminary investigation suggests that Mrs. Whitney was driving at an unusually high speed when her brakes failed. Mrs. Whitney's daughter, Julia...
He fixed Marion's car to make it look like an accident. Now he's going to steal all her money, too. How could I have been so stupid? I can't believe I didn't see it before.
Wait just a minute.
I just never would have suspected that Virgil had killed my daddy. I just never would have thought that.
Your daddy?
I can't believe.
Your daddy?
Why didn't you just tell me the truth? You used me.
I'd do it again. He killed my father.
You don't know that.
I know that. I know it with every fiber of my being. I just can't prove it.
Terry, look, you've made a new life for yourself. Don't waste it on these things that aren't real.
No, I can just pick it up like a book we didn't finish.
I know that. I've got a lot to apologize for.
No.
No, I should have done it a long time ago.
There's no time to do it.
Yeah. If I hadn't left you, none of this would have ever happened to you.
It's a little late for that, don't you think?
I know that. That's what hurts. Been apart too long. I left you, and I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. I'm sorry.
You. I really did.
Terry, I never stopped.
Don't you call me Terry anymore. Terry died a long time ago, and you were a part of that.
My God, Virgil. Already you're thinking about her money.
No, honey. I only meant...
Isn't it enough that we've already moved into her house?
Honey. We don't have to talk about it right now.
You know that I am just sick about paying out to those vultures.
I know.
I may not be very bright, but I know we shouldn't be throwing away good money,
hear from you again.
Well, I'm glad you came. Because I owe you an apology. I know that you've worked hard for what you have, and you'd like to keep it. I understand that. We could make a lot of money together.
Go on.
There's a lot of public auctions coming up. Fine horse farms that can't break even. I intend to buy them up. Lukas is backing me, so you can see where I'm headed.
Well, I wish you all the best.
No. I need you.
Oh, really?
I run the money, you run the horses.
I don't trust you.
Well, that's good, because I don't trust you. Now, you can do what you want with your end of the money. You can squander it away for all I care. But one thing I do care about is winning. And you're the best horse trainer around.
So you notice.
I've never seen anything like it in my life. Your strategy, your intuition, the way you glide your hand over their smooth, firm bodies, looking for one little intrusion that would cause a distraction. It's like you know what they're thinking every minute.
I wish I knew what you were thinking right now.
I think you do. I think you're the most exciting man I've ever met in my life.
You are an incredible woman. There's a tender girl inside there after all.
But a girl with a certain lifestyle, I don't invest in failure.
Now, I like a woman who tells you right out she's looking out for herself.
I don't think you have what it takes to keep a woman like me.
After Saturday, I will.
The Virginia Stakes?
Mm-hmm.
You think you're going to win?
Oh, yeah. I'm going to win me $1 million cup and as many bets as I can lay off. And then after that,
aren't y'all going to invite me to join you? Oh, you remember me? The wife?
Julia, you're drunk.
Well, why shouldn't I be? Aren't we celebrating? Well, Mama's dead. You can spend all her money now.
All right, that's enough. Come on.
Excuse us.
Julia, I know you won't believe me, but I don't want to hurt you.
You're right. I don't believe you.
Sorry to bother you.
Well, that's all right. I had to get up in 6 hours anyway.
How are you?
I'm fine. And you?
Good. Good.
Well, now that we got that settled, you want to tell me what you're doing here at midnight? I must be nuts. You don't even know he's gonna dope Starliner.
Well, he has to win the stakes. He cannot take a chance on losing. So we'll get samples of all the medicines, and we'll take them to your friend at the Equine Research Lab. Then we'll know.
You know what? They found synthetic adrenaline. Well, what is that anyway?
It's a stimulant. It's almost impossible to distinguish from the adrenaline a horse produces naturally. It's very dangerous.
Virgil?
Loretta.
You look pretty calm.
Summertime and the living is easy.
Good. Let's hope you still feel this way after the race.
Oh, you'll get your money. Why don't you go suck on a popsicle and relax? Hector? Beat it.
Boss, we got a problem down here. They're gonna test our horse.
What? What
the hell is going on?
We're running a spot check on Starliner. We've got evidence of possible drug use.
That's ridiculous. What evidence?
Virgil, why don't you come with me? I believe you know of Miss Bevins.
Thomas, you make sure that horse is ready to run. George, I'm telling you, she's trying to frame me.
Why would she do that?
To force me to sell the stable. She's been after him from day one. She isn't going to stop until she ruined me one way or another.
Sorry to keep you all waiting.
Doc, we need to get the race started.
Well, we've done a thorough examination of this horse's skin and also an analysis of the saliva and the blood.
Man.
There's no evidence of drugs. This is a perfectly normal horse. He's quite clean.
That's impossible.
There's no indication of synthetic adrenaline?
None at all.
I guess you made a mistake.
Let's get going. We've got people waiting long enough. Virgil,
Sorry we messed you up.
Yes, sir.
Miss Bevins, I want to see you right after this race. You got some questions to answer.
You're going to have a few more to answer after my lawyers get through with you.
Starliner entering the starting gate. Racing pool last to load. They're all in line for the Virginia Stakes.
You were wrong. Terry? Isn't it wonderful to see Starliner finally getting the recognition he deserves? It was the way you handled Starliner. It's the only thing she ever handled well. And I'm going to make sure that you never haul another horse inside the Ozarks.
It's over when Virgil is depressed and desolate and all alone and in prison.
So that's what this is all about, just getting Virgil?
That's right.
You're going to spend your whole life searching for revenge. How dumb.
Not to me.
What have you done since you got out of prison? You used a lot of people, you made a pile of money.
You're drunk.
Well, I've had enough to look at you and say to myself, somewhere in there, there's a woman that I used to love.
Until her face became too ugly for you.
17 years old. If you could forgive me, maybe we both could look ahead, not back.
How do I do that, Sam?
I guess you can't. Maybe you were right. Terry did die a long time ago. I'm gonna go to bed. Let yourself out.
Sam. Sam. Hear that?
Why, sure. Used for training sometimes.
Mom didn't work that horse, huh, brother?
Sorry to do this to you, boy. But I have to know. Hey, down there.
Easy, boy. Starliner! Easy, man.
I knew you'd show up.
You bastards.
Ain't nothing but a tin whistle. I'm a pretty good horse trainer. That's all I needed to create genuine adrenaline.
Really, you?
Hey.
Terry, if there was any horse doping going on, I didn't know about it. I swear I didn't. Virgil and I started to see each other after you were in prison. After the divorce.
You know what happened to me will happen to you. He will gamble and he will lose. And he will use you. You will lose everything you have.
I know.
I need to tell you something. I know that Virgil killed my father, and he killed your mother. I know it sounds fantastic, and I can't prove it right now, but sure as I'm standing here before you, it's true. You gotta leave. You gotta get out of there, get a divorce. Help me prove what he did.
I can't do that.
You can, Julia.
Tara, don't you understand? If I bring him down, I bring myself down, too. Everything I have is tied up in him now. What'll I have left? No, what'll I do?
Julia?
You look lovely. You're not so bad yourself, Loretta. It's a party, Hector. You ever have any fun, Loretta?
You get my fun looking at money. Now.
Gonna do to me what you did to Terry or my mother. Poor dumb Julia. It's taken me 3 years to figure out how dumb I've been.
No. No. You are the only one that I ever loved. You. Here, Hector.
Where'd you get this?
What are you talking about?
Funny money, Virgil. That's what I'm talking about.
You're not serious.
What's the real stuff? I know you have it. You just won the damn derby.
Look, that is straight from the bank. You are mistaken here.
Believe you, Judge, for this.
Loretta, I wouldn't stiff you.
Virgil. I liked you. I carried you. Go back in that house. Come back with my money.
Don't think I won't. I took out Frank Headley. I erased your mother, and I will choke the life out of you. Now give me my money. All of it. Now.
Virgil Chance, you're under arrest. Suspicion of fixing equestrian sporting events. You're also under investigation for murder. The deaths of Frank Headley and Marion Whitney.
You know something, Virgil? You really are dumb.
Girl, don't you even think about it. I don't mind tripping up someone like Loretta. She deserves it.
Hey, where did you get all that counterfeit anyway?
If I told you, I'd have to kill you.
Della Ray, thank you.
No problem.
I don't know about y'all, but I hate to waste a perfectly good party. Terry? Mr. Galvin, may we have this dance?
I'd be enchanted, ladies. Oh, man. You know what? On one condition.
What's that?
Just call me Sam.